In MathScaled, you're interacting with shapes, and the shapes have an assigned weight before the puzzle starts. And it's your job to sort of use the scales that are in the puzzle and move the shapes around until you can find a way to balance the shapes on the scales. There's two supports that we integrated into this. One that allows us to have an open exploration of the relationships of the shapes, and we call that the comparotron. The comparotron has two modes. You can open the comparotron where you can explore the shapes and find relationships of equivalence. And each time you find a relationship of equivalence, it gets added to this banner of equivalence keys around how the shapes are related to each other. You can always access the comparatron's banner when you're in the puzzle solving mode, so that you can use the information you found from the comparatron in the context of the puzzle. So that's one support that we integrated with the intent of letting people have open exploration and find the relationships of the shapes to assist them in solving the puzzle. The second integrated support that we have is the ability to label the shapes. So again, we used a scratch pad terminology for adding numbers to the shapes. One of the things that we like about the way that we used a scratch pad analogy is that people can really put whatever values they want on the shapes. And given that they're all relatively weighted, if you started by labeling a shape like the hourglass with a 4, and it was balanced with a triangle and two diamonds, then you might decide that the triangle is a 2 and the diamonds are 1s, and then you would find balance with 4 on either side. Alternatively, another student might think the hourglass is a 1. Then they would maybe conclude that the triangle is worth half and each of the diamonds are worth a quarter. Both are completely legitimate solutions to the problem, but we're allowing that because it's an open writing, labeling scratch pad analogy.